So, who's Rig Club? We're Drillmec's Australian and New Zealand agent. Drillmec, basically, after taking an internal review on a global basis, they identified our region as as high strategic importance. Drillmec are very, very committed here to the Australasian energy sectors. And they also understand and are really, really concentrating, which you'll hear a little bit more about, but the importance of customer care and after-sales support. And basically the requirement to actually have that local support and also stock held here in Australia. So we've got experience in sales, on the procurement, commissioning, operating, training and maintenance and refurbishment of Drillmec equipment. The people inside our company have come up from the from your side of the fence, from the drilling contractor side, and sort of our guys have sort of a lot of experience working as rig managers, OH&S, and on the maintenance side from a drilling company perspective. And we commenced as agent in late April 2013, so it is still. We are a new agent and it's a new relationship with Drillmec, but one at the moment which we're enjoying. So aside from the Drillmec agency, we also offer services to the onshore oil and gas sector on the drilling, HS&E, well installations, and also on the equipment or mechanical side of things. We offer company men, field rig management services to the drilling contractors, call-out maintenance and scheduled maintenance services, and equipment auditing, and OH&E. Our focus is, as Drillmec agent is to sell, promote and market their products, and Drillmec has a number of product lines, which is obviously the drilling rigs, the MR series, the HH series, the land rigs, the jack-up and barge rigs, but also the mud pumps and mud tank systems. So, and we can also assist, if you don't go with the mud pumps and the mud systems, we've also got expertise in packaging mud pumps and mud systems. So we're now getting well positioned to provide the local Drillmec services now that we've been on board for the last 5 months. We've got a dedicated sales manager, the after sales service and customer care. So we've been involved in the training and commissioning with SWMS at Caboolture. We're providing call out services, maintenance services, and with spare parts for Australia and New Zealand, where basically the stock for the equipment currently in Australia is on its way. And this will be the first time that Drillmec's held this quantity of spares here in Australia, which is obviously an investment on their behalf to just increase the after-sales support. We're based in Brisbane, out of Richlands. We've also got a 24-hour hotline for our customers who have Drillmec equipment for call-out. On the equipment and maintenance side, the equipment guys have got a good understanding of plant use on basic drilling programs. Very familiar with servicing drill spreads. They've got a very good understanding of the compliance aspects, the safety and operational requirements to operate here in the Australian market. I've sort of already touched base on what we do. But we have expertise in these areas through the guys. We also offer field rig management and drilling personnel to drilling contractors, and that's basically just provide assistance that any drilling contractors may require that need additional expertise. We don't really do the very, very short term side of things. It's more when drilling contractors may have a business improvement program which they'd like to execute, or they'd like us to have a look at an underperforming rig, that side of things. So the coaching and development is pretty important. We really try and share, the guys really try and share their knowledge amongst the drill crews at the various levels. And we concentrate on trying to improve the efficiency of the drill spreads. We also provide OCRs or company men to the industry. And so this is also a service which we offer. You'd be familiar with what the company man role is on site in terms of looking after the drilling contractors or the service providers which are on site and assisting them on a day-to-day basis. Safety and training, we've got a small OH&S team and we basically help our clients to establish safe working environments and work practices. We offer sort of project safety management, developing safety management plans, risk management tools, operational risk assessments, and also get involved actually on site in a drilling operation if requested, looking after safety for our clients. So there's sort of the project stuff and there's also the in-field support. So we always do play safety first. It's obviously very, very important to the industry here. We've got a good track record in safety. Our guys provide, you know, some technical leadership. Some of our people are very experienced. For those of you who know them would know their backgrounds. And we've got a pretty good comprehensive service provided. We've sort of concentrated on each pillar in terms of what drilling service providers require in their day-to-day operations. So that's the introduction to Rig Club. Thank you, and happy to take any questions at any time. Please feel free to approach. And I'd just like now to introduce Stefano Angeli from Drillmec.
Buongiorno, good morning, everybody. Thank you for coming here. Thank you, Mark, for the nice presentation. And this is the news of Drillmec. We have done this marriage with Rig Club in order to avoid the problem we had in the past. So now I think we will have good after-sale service. Four new rigs just arrived in Australia. So from there, we think we will restart again our business here in Australia. So just a few minutes to give you a presentation of Drillmec. Drillmec is, I'm Stefano Angeli, I'm the Vice President responsible for the sales of the company worldwide. Drillmec is part of Trevi Group. Trevi Group has two main activity. One is the construction, and the company is Trevi and Solmec. And the other one is oil and gas, Petrobel and Drillmec. We have the same scheme. In both fields, we have a drilling contractor and the rig manufacturer. So for Solmec, that is the manufacturer of rigs for foundation, is very well, everybody knows Solmec. We have about 200 rigs working in Australia. And the drilling contractor is Trevi. For what concerns the oil and gas, the manufacturer of rig is Drillmec, and as a backup, there is Petrobel, that is a drilling contractor. Drilling contractor that has only automatic hydraulic rigs and are now concentrated in South America. They have about a fleet of about 15 rigs, and they use this company to test our equipment. This is the global presence in the world. We have five factories. The main one is in Italy, in Milan, near Milan. Later on, second factory, it's about 500 people here. Second factory is in Houston. And from where we produce the equipment for all the American continent. The third one in Belarus, you know that apart from US with more than 2,000 drill rigs, the second market in the world, or maybe the third, if don't consider China, is Russia. At the moment there is about 800 rigs working there. So we have decided to open a factory there. And what we do in this factory? Mainly we do the steel job, the machine, drawworks, mud pumps, SCR are coming from Italy, but the steel job, mass extractor, mud system are manufactured there, giving advantages to the clients from Russia. And we have a workshop in the Emirates, in Fujairah, and now we open also Drillmec India, also there for producing rig for the Indian market. Plus we have other company, especially in you know, in Canada, in Mexico, in Colombia. This is Drillmec branches. And in the blue spot you see the presence. The blue spot are the Drillmec agents. And in most of this country we have also after sales service available. Now we will start also in Australia. This is our factory in Italy, it's about 330,000 square meter. And this is the picture of our factory. Now, this is a kind of standard situation. Here you can see there is a 6 months up, so we are able to do rig up about 6 weeks at the same time. This is the volume. It's been increased. So with acquisition and the opening of new factory, so we start to see so up to 2006 Drillmec was a small company about a little bit more than $100,000 turnover, but this year we will end with about $550 million, about 60 rigs. Drillmec start activities in 96, but we took over very old and famous company in Italy. Here you can see some of them, Massarenti, Ballerini, this is an Italian company, and also American company, Brown Industry. Massarenti has been founded in 1929. When we take over the company in 96, it was not only taking over the factory, but also all the experience and the know-how of these people. This is old company using Drillmec rigs all around the world. And this is the major customer. We are between our clients, the major drilling contractor, like neighbors, like Weatherford, like Saipem, IDC, ADC, Egyptian Drilling Company. All these companies have quite big number of rigs from Drillmec. And as you can see, we are present in more than 40 countries. Drillmec is a certified manufacturer. We have 6 API licenses. We have also we are working with also GHOST for the Russian, and we are qualified both for American Petroleum Institute, that is the American side, and DMD, that is the European side. This is some of the major deals we have done in the last 5 years. In the center, you see these two artificial islands. This is a 3,000 horsepower in Kazakhstan. The rig has been sold to Saipem. And 3 rigs in the Mexico, 1,500 horsepower. Russia and Mexico, we have sold 3 complete offshore drilling package, 2 to 3,000 horsepower for Gulf of Mexico and 1 to 2,000 horsepower for the Caspian Sea. Australia, these 4 fully automatic sand rig to SWMS. Iraq, in the last 4 years, we sold 28 land drilling rigs. It's our main market at the moment. And South America, where we sold 2 3,000 horsepower rigs. You can see that we are quite spread out all around the world, and also the level of equipment. As a 3,000 horsepower, Drillmec is number one in the world as number of rigs supplied in the last 3 years. A short presentation of our what we produce. First of all, land rigs. We have a range from 1,000 to 3,000 horsepower. Some information about the rigs on picture. And the last innovation is the hydraulic swing lift. So instead of elevating rig up the mast with cable, we decided to change and to be done by hydraulic pistons to be much more safer than in the past. This is some project. This is the artificial island, the 2 weeks we supply to Kazakhstan, to Cyprus. This is the picture in summertime. This is quite complicated rigs, because in summertime the temperature reaches 40 degrees plus, in wintertime minus 40, so there is an excursion of about 80 degrees between summer and winter. This is a workover rigs. You can see a rig that we sold to Libya with mounted on wheels. The range is from 500 to 1,000 horsepower. Later on, I will show a demo with the new rigs we are selling now in Europe, and we would like also to propose here in Australia. We know that to be quite a big demand of workover rigs, so we will have later on a short demo of these new rigs. This is some picture in Egypt, Oman, Spain. And the cyber control room for up to 3 operators. This is the something that we are developing in the last, so nowadays nobody likes to stay outside, everybody on a cyber chair with all the joystick. So what we have started first with our automatic hydraulic rigs, now we are moving also to the conventional rig. Mud pumps, we have a range from 600 to 2,200 horsepower. And draw works, we have both chain, the old system, and gear-driven draw works. Here you can see one of the gear-driven, new technology in this field. Again, up to from 500 to 4,500 horsepower, mainly for offshore operation. With some information, some picture, Mexico, Poland. And hydraulic top range, top drive, with a range from 100 to 350 horsepower. We are selling a lot of these top drive, mainly for upgrading the mechanical rig. We sold many to Russia, and these attachments are mounted on Russian rig, Chinese rig. It's quite successful business for us. And also recently we have started production of new electric top drive that will be ready for sales in the beginning of next year. PCR, power control room. As you can see, we produce all the components of a drill rig, so mass, substructure, drawers, mud pump, PCR, so that we can avoid dangerous interface with other company. So everything is done by Drillmec, 100% tested and delivered to the client. This is the new generation of drilling rigs. We have also several rigs here in Australia, and the range is from 750 to 2,000 horsepower. Is fully automatic, can be fully automatic, but also semi-automatic and fully hydraulic. This is picture showing, of course, is a little bit exaggeration, but you know, this is the our 1,500 horsepower hydraulic rig, and this is the 1,500 automatic conventional rig you can see the difference and you can understand the advantages of this rig, mainly for moving, space, automatization. These two rigs can do the same job, but of course this is much bigger, so you need more time, more loads to plow. Automatization, of course, now I saw the land rig have this kind of automatization, but this was done since 15 years in our rigs. DMS, drilling mate system, this is a system in order to have remote assistance and drilling monitoring system, troubleshooting and alarm system. Nowadays, some of the job site are very remote area, so it's necessary to have the system so you can control from remote and correct the malfunction of the rigs. This can be done by satellite. This is, you see, one of our rigs, HH220, and some picture of the rigs we have all around the world. We have about 150 rigs working, Italy, France, Australia. This is the rig that Robbie will present better, HH75 Island, Colombia, 1,500 horsepower rig. This is the distribution of the world of the rigs. We have, as I told you, more or less 150 rigs, and you can see spread out all around the world. The highest concentration is in South America, where we have more than 70 rigs working. And we see that when this rig, at the beginning, is very difficult for us to sell this rig because it's something new. But as soon as the rig start to work, a little bit problem at the beginning, but later on, when the people get used on them, there is a big success. So we have done a lot in South America, Europe. We start to sell now also in Russia and India, China, we have some rigs in China, and of course Australia and Indonesia. And something new for Drillmec, in the last 3 years we started also to promote offshore, and we have possibility to sell components like draw works, mud pumps, derrick, skidding system, rotary table, power tank, but also the complete packages. I told you before that we have just delivered two packages to Gulf of Mexico, 2,000 horsepower, and one to Caspian Sea, to Turcoil. Now the rigs are going to be mounted and we start operation beginning of next year. And recently we have also signed a contract for a walkover rig for the North Sea, for Statoil. And it will be something innovative because this rig will work together with the drilling rig. So it will be 3,000 horsepower conventional rig and this is a small 1,000 horsepower rig that will do the workover. So one rig will drill and the other one will do workover simultaneously. This is the service we gave to the clients, and as I told you before, the most important things for us to have a local partner that give the service locally. For example, in Australia, you know, there is 8 hours difference from Italy to Australia, there is about 25 hours trip to come here, problem with visa, work visa. So what we have done with Rick Lab is to create a local structure here. They are very expert, they have several technicians that work also with our rigs for several years. Stock of spare parts, so that if you need somebody, in few hours can come to your job site. And we are doing the same in other all around the world, step by step. The biggest spot we have is Iraq. In Iraq we have 20 technicians, so that available 24 hours a day. Stock of spare parts, that is very difficult to send spare parts. Also if you have the parts on the shell in Italy, it takes 1 month to reach the job site. So you can understand the advantages to have the spare parts there and to have the people And another important thing is the local people. They speak the same language. They are coming from the same family sometimes. That is very, very important. And we experienced that, especially in Iraq. At the beginning, we sent there about 10 Italian technicians, and you know, some problem of communication, misunderstanding. As soon as we pull out our Italians, no problem. So we are very happy, and they talk every day. And same, we have other service available. We have one in Fujairah, the Emirates, for the Middle East, for Saudi Arabia and Kuwait. And another one is in Romania, for the Central Europe. One is in Poland, UK. So we are step by step acting on this subject in order to have after-sales service available all around the world. Training, we have certified training. This is our simulator. We have a simulator simulating the condition of work. This is, we have two. One is in Italy, in our factory in Milan, and the other one is in Houston. Okay, this is the vision. We want to be leader in the world, and we want to provide budget and our mission to provide budget and quality-oriented drilling companies with a premier, moderate price at the delivery, and solutions that are consistently well-designed, robust, easy to operate, easy to maintain, and continuously updated. All designed, manufactured, and follow up with well-prepared, friendly, and flexible team. This is basically for them that you can read. But anyway, this is just a brief presentation. If you have any question, I'm here to reply. Now I think we go to the most interesting part. This is only kind of presentation. First of all, very glad that is our partner here in Australia, Drillmec. Now Massimo, that is the sales area manager, I think everybody knows him, will present what is our best equipment, is automatic hydraulic drilling rigs.
HS rig, okay, and the main important class of rig are from the small one, 75 ton, HS75. Then I give you some idea about HH100, is 100 metric ton capacity. HH120 is 200 ton metric ton capacity. HH300 and HH350. What you see from this picture, the engineering of this rig is look like the same. So this is one of the first HH75. This is what was a special program project. It's one of the most simple rig that we have for CBM exploration. We have 25 of this rig working this moment in China. The solution was find very fast rig for moving and drilling. So this rig, if you see, is mounted on skid frame. In which way we can move this skid frame? Directly with a truck. In this case, we proposed to the client Astra truck from Fiat Iveco, okay, from the Fiat Group. But of course, they can mount it in any type of truck, local content, no problem. This is the standard truck to give you the dimension of the truck, so it's very standard truck, very common truck, without problem to go on the road, absolutely, also here in Australia. The rig is mounted on a skid frame, self-elevating. Everything is on this skid frame. The skid is only around 37 ton for the rig. And this is the configuration in transport. So maximum, the total weight of this rig, truck more rig, is 50 ton. All the HH rig have a telescopic mast. In this case, we have range 2 for this type of rig. And here you have stroke, free stroke from the top drive is 50 meter, and the capacity is 75 ton. Hydraulic top drive, in this case, we have a maximum speed around 150 RPM, and maximum torque is 3,600 kilogram meter. All the HH rig have small or bigger our vertical drill pipe container system. All the drill pipe are inside these pipe beams. So in this case, the client can have, for example, three different configuration. And you can have 5 inch, 4.5 and 3.5, for example. Or you can have 10 beams or 11 beams and a storage of up one more of 100 single joint drill pipe. Of course, so you can also have drill collar storage capacity. The handling in this case, these are not full automatic rigs, okay, it's a semi-automatic. The handling of the drill pipe is done by the crane that is incorporated on the rig. So the people by the crane can take the pipe from the beams, go with the pipe on the mouse hole, and the top drive can translate in horizontal, go on the vertical of the mouse hole, take the drill pipe and drill it. During the drilling operation, the operator can prepare the second drill pipe on the mouse hole. Sorry. Very easy to move and rig up the rig, absolutely, because the truck with the rig arrive, rises the ramp, then the stabilizer lifting the skidding with the rig. When the skidding is in position, the truck can go out and the rig is ready to drill. This is the standard configuration of this type of rig. If you see, it's very, very, very simple. In this case, also we have the driller cabin because for the weather condition in this side. And here there are the dimensions of the rig. So you see that the rig is maximum is 18 meter for 10 meter. So you have 180 square meter for the rig. And here again is the view of the rig. For to have this fast moving, the rig is also the drill column cabin is self-elevating. So you arrive with your truck with the control cabin and you don't need any crane to set up the rig. And this is the simple drilling console, classic, for this type of rig. This is, there are no, in this case, we don't have a computer, everything is by joystick, classical mode. And here you have some picture of the setup of the rig. You're right. This is a new, another new version of this rig. In this case, the client asking us the same type of rig, but raised rig. This rig is in this moment in Indonesia, okay? So we have raised rig, 75 ton, pull down 20 ton, and torque is 3,000, is around 3,200 decalitre per meter. Well, this is some future of the link that you can see. There is a cabin, drill floor, the telescopic mast, also here, and your pipe beams with all the pipe there. Also, hydraulic top drive. As Mr. Angeli say, all these components are made from Drillmec. So if the client have any special requirement, we are able to satisfy any special engineering from the client. In this case, we have maximum the RPM from 50 up to 150 RPM. Here you can see very well the pipe beams positioning, drill floor, and the hydraulic power tank. The control cabin, also in this case, is self-elevating. If you see, it's much more high than the first rig. And also the drill cabin is much more bigger because here the client asks also possibility to position inside here the BOP control system. Much higher, why? Because there are one hydraulic and automatic BOP trolley on the rig. So there are no WP. Here you have the trolley, and here you have two automatic hydraulic cylinder to move the WP in the center of the well. Also, this is the design of the rig during the moving. To reduce the rig, is only necessary in this case move the soundproof of the motor and of the engine of the rig. As I say, it's a range 3, so the maximum height is 27 meter. Also, this rig, to move the pipe and drilling, you need you use the crane incorporated in the rig. So you see the top drive open, translating horizontal, take the drill pipe on the mouth hole, go up and drill. This is the general view that is the same in all this concept of rig. Of course, this rig can also mounted on a semi-trailer in different solution. Okay, this is the rig, the same rig but mounted on semi-trailer. Then the 100 ton rig. 100 ton rig is little more bigger than the rig before, but the concept is exactly the same, if you see. In this case is range 3, okay, 100 metric ton capacity, and in this case, for our client, so for this client, the top drive is exactly the same of the rig before. Also here we have telescopic mast. You see this is the fixed part of the mast, and this is the telescopic system. And working stroke, in this case, as is range 3, is 16 meter, because maybe you have drill pipe around 14 meter, then you have 2 meter free for some operation or some junction, some accessory that maybe you need. Top drive, in this case, is with the 3 hydraulic motor, and it's the same of the before rig. In this case, it's little more bigger the pipe, the drill pipe container. And in this case, you can have your storage around 132 joint for 5-inch drill pipe. For positioning the drill pipe, you don't need a crane in the field. You have all the beams can be transported by a semi-trailer. You only need one forklift to position in the pipe beams on the ground. Then the same crane can lift the pipe beams and position the pipe beams on the substrate of the rig. This is the rig in transport condition. As you see, it's very compact because it's only 12 meters. And very important, the transport of all these three is with top drive mounted. So when the rig arrives, it's ready to drill. Okay. Okay, in this case is the same view of before. So in this case we have 27 meter high the rig. And also the 100 is only 10 meter for 18, exactly the 75. Rear cordon cabin, similar to the before rig. But we have also one version starting from the 100 rig, that is the full automatic system. In this case, the full automatic, why? Because all the pipe handler system on this rig is full automatic. In this case, if you see, you have much more beams on the rig. This is now a video of 100 rigs from South America. This is very particular rig in this case because the client asked us possibility to do also a workover, and we use our full automatic system also for workover operation. So you see in this case, as we have the full automatic system, the crane is quite different. And we use the small crane to elevate it, the big crane, because it's the same crane, this one, that we use, that contains the drip pipe control. I think that the video is much more clear than the word. As you can see, there are no people on the drill floor. Everything is automatic. So, no people touch the drill pipe. And what is very important at this moment, power is leaving for automatic. This is a system for the small rods for workover, and you can see the precision. All these operations are from the control cabin from the driller. So you have the control of the whole operation. So you see that this system, the high precision of this system, also to move the small drill pipe for that to use it for the workover operation. Of course, this is not a workover rig. This is one only modification that under client required. You see the clamp, everything is full automatic. Then we have the range of the bigger rig, okay, from 220, 300, and 350. As Mr. Angel said before, on all this rig, we Drillmec produce all the accessories for the rig. So we have the rig, VCR generators, control cabin, automatic monitoring system for the rig, possibility of skidding system on this rig, mud pump and mud system. This is a general view of this type of rig. All the rigs are exactly the same configuration. So we have, you have the main port and the skid, hydraulic power unit, as you see, semi-trailer mounted, top drive, mast, telescopic mast, rotating tower, and piping. Pipe basket for the drill pipe. HA220 is all this rig runs free. In this case, the maximum the top drive is 3,370 decan per meter. Rest 3 is in the 16 meter for top drive stroke. This is the main field of the top drive. In this case, we arrive up to around 200 RPM revolution per meter. The system in this case, if you see the rig is more bigger than from 11, we can have in this case 17 pipe beams. It seems that you can have store here about 272 joint for 5-inch drill pipe. Also, this rig is semi-trailer mounted. In this case, of course, is quite more little more bigger, and also in this case you can transport the rig with the top drive mount. This is the semi-trailer that you can see. In this case, this is the dimension of the rig. If you see maximum, we arrive anyway around 30 meters when the mast is full open, okay? And the pipe beams, you have rent 3, so it's 40 meters. This is the dimension of the rig during drilling operation. The maximum space that you need only for the rig is around 20 meters for 35 meters. You think that this is one general view, and if you see that it's 200 ton rig, but it's very compact, out of work. 300 ton. Also, this rig is look like the same. Okay, range 3 is single, 200 ton in capacity, 30 meter ton pull down. Sorry. Top drive, of course, is more bigger. It's like 5,024 meter. This is our top drive. In this case, you reach around 200 RPM. Hydraulic automatic pipe bender is exactly also like before 17 vertical drill pipe. And also this rig is bigger, but you can move the rig on semi-trailer directly. And if you can see here, we have one of these rigs, for example, in Italy, for the National Electrical Agency for geothermal investigation, and they need deep geothermal drilling, but this semi-trailer can move on the mountain without problem. In this case, the maximum height of the rig is around 31 meters when it's full open. And you have 20 meters in front and 32 meters length. Approximately for this rig, big rig, you need around maybe 2,800 square meter for the complete drilling site. So with my system, my pump, generator, and everything. The bigger one is the HH350. It's 1,600 horsepower. Of course, this is more bigger. Top drive in this case is really with much more power because we have 6,500 decanewton per meter. It seems that in this case we have 4 hydraulic motor instead of 3. Okay. And here you can see the drill floor with the hydraulic top drive and hydraulic power tank. Also in this case, the same system, and in this big rig you can reach around 18 joint drill pipe for each beam, for 5, and if you use 4, you can have 300 joint. Also this one is the same semi-trailer like the HH300, and if you see the spatial design of this semi-trailer, to the don't have problem in the moving in critical condition. The same design of before is exactly the same dimension and final the same weight for the rig. Don't change nothing in this case. This is the hydraulic power tonne. And also, if you see here, don't have any people working near the center of the well. And the driller controls the hydraulic power tonne directly from the driller cabin. So time and safety is very high. So what we want to focus on this type of rig is that there is sure cost reduction, improvement of the safety, environmental friendly, and improve the performance in the drilling operation. This is now this is a video that we can show, where you can see one HH220 rig in operation. This is a skidding system for this type of rig, for example, to give you an idea. Now it's very common that we have many requests from the energy contractor to have rig able to operate on pad drilling, so mounted on a skidding system. And you understand that what is very important here, that in this configuration, you can move rig and all the drill pipe together. So normally, for well, distance between the well around 18 meters, you need around from 5 to 8 hours maximum to move the complete rig, without crane, without nothing. Okay, here you can see more clear standard drilling operation. You have the arm that put the drill pipe on the mouthhole, come down the top drive, connect to the pipe, then go up. There is a sensor inside the mouthhole, you see, when the drill pipe go out from the mouthhole, automatically the arm take another drill pipe and put the drill pipe in the mouthhole. So during the operation, after you start, you have 3 drill pipe ready to use. So if you see also here, all the operation are without people. Anyway, you have this video inside the DVD that we give you, and then you can take a look with, because it's around 15 minutes. This is what's happened in one conventional rig and HH rig. So you see that it's quite different, the operation. The same. Complete control from the driller, from the control cabin of all the drain pipe moving. This is what's happened in one mechanical rig, and this is the operation in one HS rig. So you see that you have three people here handling manual, so dangerous, take attention. In this case, you don't need absolutely people for drilling connection. See, what we're talking about is deep operation. I think that is very more dangerous than what you can do with one HS rig. On the new rig now, we have the new style for the control cabin. In this case, the control cabin inside the control cabin. And you see the operator sit down here, and they have four control panels and only joystick left and side of the position. This is the new layout of the new cyber control cabin. The operator working with more safety without so much stress. So you have the central control side is, you have the control panel here, touch screen, and here there are the small right and left control panel. The four control panels are mainly one for HPU and MAT system control, weight indicator for the drilling operation, automatic drilling, top drive parameters. Here you can set all the parameters of the drilling operation, and here you have a look of all the control of the pipe handle system. So you know in each pipe beams which type of drill pipe you have, or the color, or all of that. Okay, this is what is you have left and right side. So from the left side, the operator have only two joysticks for top drive and power top, and one joystick here only for top drive joystick. The driller, drilling manager, drilling engineer can decide to change the parameter of the drilling operation. This system is, okay, automatic interface to our system, but also is possible automatic interface with the system that, for example, PESM, that is very useful here in Australia, so there are no problem absolutely. The drilling main system is permit the remote assistance from drilling technician from Italy. The full control of the drilling monitoring parameter of the rig. Truly short control of if something strange appears on the rig. And alarm system. So mainly is you have one DMS manager with all the software and the hardware. Then you have, and this is in the rig, and on this software and hardware is connected, or our Drillmec control center for the assistance, or maybe your office, in other side, not on rig side. So the software on the rig, you can have the control of the most important, all the parameter of the rig that you need. So the control, the software is made under current requirements, so depend from the mud pump, how many mud pump, type of generator, how many tank you have for the mud system, everything. Drillmec. In Drillmec we can check the status of the rig. We can make some assistance for the software by remote from Italy. It's possible to have audio and video call in real time with the rig side. There are camera video on the drill cabin and on the rig. And it's possible to check the geographic location of the rig. The client have from another office outside the drill site can have the control of what's happening in real time during the drilling operation. But respect to the mechanical rig, maybe if you never use this type of hydraulic or HH rig, maybe you see that sometimes bad mechanical rig is much more complicated. But we are sure that it's much more easy finally after one good training. And in Italy we have one big police station where the people can come there and do the training exactly like a drilling site. So they can make a program for the drilling operation. What you see now in this moment is exactly what's happened on drilling site. So they do drilling training on pipe elevator, power tongue, everything. This is what is now, what we have now in this moment for the classic driller cabin. Okay, and now we are under construction, the new one for the cyber control. So our client sent to Italy normally 3-4 drillers per time, and they stay there and drilling. Exactly. You can have a program for drilling for the drill profile, for example, and if the driller don't working properly, you have all the alarm not working and advise the driller that you're doing some error or some wrong operation during the drill. So what we explain is that sure, this type of rig are fast moving because all the rig are mounted on semi-trailer. You can see which way this rig can move on the road. And very important is the number of loads. This is exactly the number of loads that you need to move one drill site with one HH300 or HH120. Totally, you need no more of 40 loads for everything. And we know that, for example, one mechanical rig, maybe 1,500, you only to move only the rig, maybe you need 70 or 80 loads. Then you have mud pump, mud system, generator, and that. In this case, is exactly what's happened during one moving of this type of rig. So of course you understand that you save time and save money. Environmental friendly, why? Because first, for example, 30 meter for when this rig is open and 50 meter. Very reduced footprint. This is one rig that working in New Zealand, is one HA220, and they got permission certification for working in one natural park. They do all the tests for leakage of oil, gasoil, noise, for example, transport in this part. And you see that this rig working without problem for the animals. There is a river here, so absolutely not 100% of protection, but very, very high protection for the environment. But this happened not only in open space, because open space is very, 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 very easy. Now I show you one 300 rig in Germany for very deep geothermal drilling. This is 300 ton, and this rig working exactly in the center of the city. Without any problem. So, very reduced footprint, no noise, people around the rig working. Maybe this is not possible here in Australia with your regulation, but this is what's happened with this type of rig. So, of course, as you see from the video, if in one traditional rig you need maybe six people only for the rig, with the HH, three people are enough, without problem. Drilling performance. With this type of rig, you can reach maximum for experience from our client, tripping in about 48 joints per hour. This is an example of three wells in South America, but if something wants, we can send you more history about this and more example. This is one well where the client estimate around 23 days for drilling operation with HH220, they say 8.5 days. The second well, they say 7.5, and the third well, they say 5.5. So, respect to the program of the main contractor, these three wells, they save around more of 3 weeks. So we understand that it's a lot of money also for your contractor. So fast moving, but not only for the rig, because the rig is mounted on semi-trailer, but we also can provide mud pump mounted on semi-trailer under client requirement, and in this case, of course, depends from the road regulation, but finally the steel is steel and the weight is this one, the dimension is this, so when it's possible, sometimes this is one of the best solutions. I know that main country like Australia, they like this type of solution. This is some example of mud pump mounted on semi-trailer. So there are different type of solution, depend of course from the size of the mud pump, if are electric or diesel. Mud system, the same. In this type of rig, maybe you have 200 cubic meter or 250 cubic meter of capacity, which seems like 5 or 6 tank. So we can produce these tanks. Genset trailer, exactly the same. All this is mounted on semi-trailer for fast moving. So there are HQ trailer, PCF trailer, everything for very, very fast moving. The gauss also can be mounted on semi-trailer directly, self-elevating, so you arrive with your semi-trailer, self-elevating, and connect the gas directly to the rig. And same for BOP accumulator and more. This is some example I see you before about the possibility of have all this rig mounted on a skid system. So increase performance, reduction of the cost, safety and rig operation, environmental protection, and of course final, this is money for the drilling contractor and the drilling company and the energy company. I think that now we can take coffee after maybe 20 minutes, half hour, no problem. After this we can give you presentation of the new HA slant rig from SWMS that are here in Cabourtour, so you can see this new technology developed with Shell and CNPC and Drillmec. And final, Mr. Angeli can give you one presentation about our new concept of mobile rig for workover operation. Okay, thank you.
SWMS HX 5 here in Australia, and look at the tool that you fly into the units, the concept behind this rig, and the principle of where we are and the number of innovation which this rig is going to the industry. So, first of all, this rig was a rig, this project has been involved all the globe. Because it was the initial concept started in Beijing, in China, which was involving an oil field, a gas field actually in Australia, and all the engineering has been done in Italy with the, let's say, Shell Global Engineering Group. The main three issues were, of course, the environment here in Australia, which means plus 55 degrees in bush conditions. The issue that, anyway, SWMS is a drilling contractor and is a joint venture between two companies which has different views, of course, so we need to balance all this. And the issue that Drillmec is anyway in Italy, which is 12,000 miles away, and so we need to make sure that the rig was properly engineered for this kind of condition. The challenges which has been brought to Drillmec are in principle four. And are all belong to the same one. The main one was the application of the well manufacturing concept. Means having a machine, or even a rig, which is capable to reproduce automatically the same thing in an infinitive way. And this has to be, this is a concept which is applied on big stuff where the well are pretty shallow and easy and quick to be drilled, but at the same time you need a good number in order to get the revenues. So this concept was introducing four pinpoint, which was, of course, the first one was the design in compliance with Australian rules and Shell standards, which are, as everybody knows, are the toughest in the world. Rig capable to drill from vertical to 45 degrees inclination. The principle of having full hands-free operation for drill string, for bottom hole assembly, and for casing. And the full degree hands-free operation. These were the pinpoint of this kind of project. This is the preliminary idea from which we started in March 2012, and so was having an HA75 slanted with pipe beams on trailer in order to have an automatic pipe handling system and in order to avoid all the time to load and unload the tubulars. And this is what in March 2013, which means after 12 months, we got in Italy moving. The rig is actually here under testing for traveling and for software calibration, as you can see. And just a few words about the project. The project involves a rig composed by two main groups, the rig itself and the pipe handling system. The rig itself is a standard well-known HA75 with the upgrade of the Cyber. And so which means it's a tough, robust, oil-filled proven rig. The pipe handling system has been expressly developed in order to fulfill the requirement for this specific customer and in order to fulfill the concept behind it, which is the well manufacturer. In order to achieve the full end free operation, we designed this new pipe and casing handler on mast side. This is an equipment which is capable to translate and rotate, and is capable to grab any kind of tubulars from 278 up to 13 up to 9 and 5/8, and is capable also to grab to all the torque for spinning or all these components. So it means that if you work with this grabber engaged, you can have the pipe old and you can connect directly to the top drive. The second concept was the trailer. We have all the pipes stored on this kind of trailer, and the trailer comes at each side full of pipe which has been already calibrated, and the tell has been already done and is in the software. And also the pipe handling system is integrated to the trailer. So the trailer is just arrived at each side and has to be set up and it's ready to work. We have been forced also to develop a new kind of slips according to the different requirements that we got. These newly designed slips are unique in their design and are capable to hold the weight of the string completely and holding also the torque in order to screw and unscrew equipment, including casing. So you don't need any kind of backup tongue or stuff like that. This is due to this length operation that has to be performed. The rig is equipped with an automatic doping device for drill pipes, and all these doping operation, dope distribution operation, are included into the automatism of the rig itself. So it means that when the rig goes down to the top drive, it's been already calibrated, measured, doped, ready to go. So no man is going up and forth with brushes or grease and stuff like that. The rig is equipped with volant hands-free casing running tool, so it means that you don't need to open and close any kind of elevator, you don't need to have any kind of outside power tongue in order to screw the casing. And coming back to the point that the slips can also hold the torque, you can understand that the rig is capable on its own to screw completely the casing without anybody touching any kind of pipe, and bring also the records about the torque and about the number of turns which has been applied. So it means that you don't need any kind of third party to have this operation performed properly. This is quite a unique feature because I think this is the only 75-ton rig equipped with a cyber control chair. So by means of these three joysticks and five monitors, we can monitor all rig operation, all pipe handling system operation, and even the mud system. We can operate the pumps from there and decide which kind of strokes we want to have, how many was the delivery, and we have also integration with the rig itself. So when you screw or unscrew, the pump are automatically shut down. If the UP is engaged, you cannot operate the pumps and all this kind of stuff. The state of art rig is equipped with the state of art technology, which means laser positioning system for the top drive in order to have a precise, calibrated length positioning of the top drive itself. This is due to the grabber to coming in for anti-collision purposes. We have intelligent server sub equipment. With this server sub, is capable to wireless transmit all the data in terms of torque, turn, pull, and push to whoever or whoever we want. So it's an online data acquisition system, extremely precise, which is redundant with the rig system itself. So you always have the double value in order to be able to be compared. And then we have full integration with Shell SCADA drill software and capable to have a rig in a box able to operate from remote, which we will discuss later. The rig comes with a separate HPU, so it's not the standard design with HPU on the trailer. And HPU and doghouse come at rig side on the same skid, so it's just one load. With the substrate, with the doghouse lifted up hydraulically to the right height. Another big issue which was brought to us was the VOP handling system. The requirement of the customer was nobody has to touch the VOP with hands, because it's a suspended load, it's an hazard, and so nobody has to touch. So Drillmec decided to develop a new component which is capable to hold the BOP completely, to incline it to the right inclination required, to rotate it, and to translate it. So in this world, in this way you can assemble your BOP offline, and then by main of this device you can bring it to the center of the well, and you can just place on top of your flange, and then you just need to screw the bolts and nuts. This is how it comes with the rig. And this is the how the pipeline system works. The system has been slightly speed up just for presentation purposes, of course, we will see from the people moving. But as you can see, the system is capable to pick up the pipe from the trailer, put it on the grabber, and all this sequence is completely automatic, so you don't need to say to the rig, do it. He knows he has to do. And the grabber just rotates and puts the pipe ready to go into the center of the well. And this is the pull out of the oil, of course, sequences. It's coming from another angle. I know that some of the question will be how quick this system is, of course. And as you know, as everybody knows here, we have four rigs here sitting in Australia. Two are actually sitting in Cobulto, and one is in Dolby, and another one is in another remote area. So the first rig on which we've been capable to completely field test was in Dolby, and we can tell we're pretty satisfied with this one, despite we're still in the, let's say, shakedown period of the rig itself. We're pretty satisfied with it. We say at the moment we have two units delivered to the job sites, and in the future we are studying about, of course, improvement about this product. The first one will be a simplified version without trailer available on the market for all of the customer, which will be definitely a little bit lighter with less automation, and but let's say with other type of advantages, a little bit more versatile. The future for these rigs, which are actually in Australia, will be, first of all, this complete setup of the SCADA drill, which will be able to remotely control and operate the rigs, and let's say monitor, and if we want, change parameters of drilling as well. The development of the SCADA pipe, which means fully automatic sequence from the trailer down to the center of the well, and connection completely without, let's say, interface to the human being. Human being just confirming operation. And scaling system. And this is it for this. If you have any question, we'll be ready to reply.
Still in the phase of testing. One rig is working, the second one will work. We think that it will be a good success in Australia and all around the world. This is a pilot project. Automatization is very high level, and nobody has done a rig like this before. So it's, I think we have to be a little bit patient at the beginning, but I think the critical phase has been passed now. We hope that we can work very well in job site and we'll meet the requirement of the client. So now two words about the new generation of workover rigs. We are going to a lower level of this, not fully automatization, but you know, especially in Europe, we have new rules. ATEX is there, safety is the most important things. And there is a phase to change all the existing workover rigs. And this rig that I will present today is another pilot project, and in order to be used in Europe according with the actual rules, so it's very strict rules. So here you can see the rig, and it's fast moving, and the main features, four stabilizer, two or four extra outriggers. There is internal anchoring system, no need to dig around, all is self inside the system. Foldable outriggers, these are the main features. The advantages is a smaller footprint. See, the rig is very, very compact. No civil works. Suitable on every well site. Safer working condition. Reduce the concrete. Fast rig down, rig up, rig down. Now you can see the four stabilizers that are open. And you see the other view of the rig. You see the anchoring are internal. Power tap walk, so nobody likes to touch the pipe anymore. So this is something that is optional, but we supply with the machine. The pipe range is from 238 to 4.5 OD range for the pipe and cubic. The max tubular weight is up to 1,000 kilo. Max drilling flow rate is 4.8 meter. Filled by independent HPU. Of course, the advantage is safer working condition, faster operation. Power swivel. This is an attachment, can be added there so later. Here you can see that we have done a small trailer. The power swivel is equipped with HPU independent electronic unit. For drilling operation, the maximum pull-up is 150 ton and the working pressure 5,000 psi. ESO, the rig, of course, ESO can drill, and in that case, or re-entry, you can mount a top drive. We have done a special compact top drive with only one motor that we call the HTD250. And that is the top drive I told before, that they had a great success in the last couple of years. We have sold more than 100 units and has been mounted on mechanical rig all around the world. This is the drawings of the rig that we have built for Czech Republic. And this is another one that are building for France. So all around Europe, this new concept has been accepted, and now they are changing all the fleet to this new, safer system. And the two rigs we have done three rigs. One is a trailer, the other two are mounted on truck, and for these two rigs, we have chosen a Czech manufacturer, Tatra, that in the past was manufacturing trucks for missile for the Soviet Union, and they have a very, very strong trucks. And also, Tatra is available as in Australia, of course. So this is a slide summarizing the specification of the rig. The 90 metric ton, six line bench to double. This
this break drawbacks, this is another important innovation. This break is accepted by the European rules and can be certified, ATEX certified, that is the new system in Europe. So it's having the possibility to use joystick, not anymore manual operation. External outriggers, no mud boat, so no need of mud boat. You don't have to have the platform and spend time for setting the platform. The track is six-axis and is Tata 12 by 8, homologated for Europe. It is, I don't know if in Australia it's the same, but the problem we had in the past with Americans in Europe is the homologation. It's very difficult to homologate the daily rig if you don't have an homologated track. This track is used for normal transportation, it's also producing thousands of pieces per year, so it's homologated for travel on the road. ATEX CE, Euro 5 certified, that is the most strict regulation. So this is the benefit, and I hope that also we can, with some modification, we can also propose to Australian contractor this kind of rigs. There is the personalization, the AS system, as you have seen before the presentation of Massimo. So the way to troubleshoot from remote and to check all the rig from remote. Subtractor and working platform, so you can have the two alternatives, subtractor in case you want to have a drilling rig and working platform in case you want to have only hoist, simple hoist, and power at work. So now, as video, show the rig up of this new workover rig. This is the substructure. This rig, in this case, is track mounted. Okay, you don't see, there is no mud bolt. Stabilizer. The substructure can be elevated up to 3.5 meter, even more. Remember, it's 3.5 meter. Mast raised by hydraulic piston. This rig can work in double, 18 meters. European system, a little bit less complicated than HOIST-certified anyway, still. Catwalk. This design has been approved by OMV. Now there is a plan to substitute all the existing workover in Europe with this new kind of rigs. Of course, Drillmec is not the only one manufacturing. We have the advantage that already we have in three countries on operation. About this, I think is quite interesting for the market here in Australia. There is looks need of workover rigs will be a need in the future, and this workover rig must be safe, fast moving, and safe. And, for the rig, so So the machine is only one load. Can be moving one load. Later on, you need another two for the substructure and catwalk. So three, four loads. And later on, of course, you need for the mud system, mud pumps, depend. In which version you have, if you have drilling version, you have, you need two mud pumps, a bigger mud system, if it's workover only. But the rig itself, four loads only. And you know, the rig is only one load, the main rig, only one. Okay, thank you. I think, I don't know if you have any question. There is, of course, in our website, there is all this information. We are trying to keep all the clients updated. Massimo is sending a newsletter. I don't know if you don't receive, but if you don't receive, it's available. So every month we send out a newsletter. And of course, so our agent, Rick Clapp, is at your disposal for any things you need. And we hope that we have done the right things to change our structure here, to, you know, to have this marriage with Rick Clapp. And I'm sure that will be beneficial for everybody. So we choose one of the most expert companies here. We have good technician, good organization. I think the combination of Drillmec, that is not the Drillmec that came here 10 years ago with a small factory and not very well organized, is a different Drillmec. So we need this different organization. So we are at your disposal, whatever you need. Of course, rigs are working. There is a rig working here in Australia. But for example, workover, if you want to come to Europe to see the rig in operation. So please give us the chances to the Italians, not only to the Canadian, the American, even the RS American, because we have a factory in Houston, by the way. Give us the chance to ask, you know, to start discussion with you, to try to fulfill your requirement. Thank you. Now let's go for the barbecue.